And now the Chancel Choir and drama team present Celebrate His Name, Proclaim His Birth, a joyful Christmas acclamation by Mary McDonald and Larry Shackley, directed by Steve and Lori Comer. And it came to pass that Israel forgot the God who saved them in Egypt. They became rebellious and suffered because of their sin. The Lord was angry with his people and handed them over to their enemies, who oppressed them and ruled over them. Some wandered in the desert, hungry and thirsty. Others sat in darkness and suffering in prisons. for they had despised God's law. They were forced to labor, and when they stumbled, there was no one to help. And the people cried out in their trouble, "Lord, we have waited for you. How long will it be? Have compassion upon us and save us. Gather us and by your name deliver us. For your name is the desire of our hearts." When it was time for his promise to be fulfilled, God sent his angel to the young virgin named Mary, who was pledged to marry a man named Joseph. The angel told her, "Mary, God is with you and has looked upon you with favor. He has chosen you to bear a son, his son. The Lord will give him the throne of his father David, and he will be great. He will reign over Jacob's house forever. There will be no end to his kingdom. And all of this will happen by the power of God. Mary answered, "My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices because he has remembered me. He has done great things for me. The Mighty One has lifted up the humble and filled the hungry. Holy is his name. I am his willing servant. Let it be as you have said." As the day neared for Mary to give birth, Caesar Augustus decreed that the entire Roman Empire should register to be taxed. Everyone was to enroll in the city of ancestry. Joseph and Mary, who were descendants of David, made the long journey to Bethlehem, which was David's birthplace. When they arrived, Mary was already in labor, and Joseph anxiously sought a room for the night. But because of the crowds who had come to register for the tax, the small town was filled to capacity. Every room in the inn was taken. The owner could only offer the stable, which was the last remaining shelter.
Thank you.
That night, Mary gave birth to the Son of God. She wrapped him in cloths and laid him in a wooden manger, a feeding trough for the animals. There on the hay, which fed the cattle, lay the one who would call himself the bread of life. Living bread given to feed the world, to fill the empty, to satisfy the needy, so that they would never hunger again. In the nearby hills, shepherds took turns watching their flocks. Suddenly, in the darkness was broken with a piercing light, and the angel of the Lord appeared before them. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I have come to bring you good news, news of joy for the world. A child has been born in Bethlehem, a Savior. You will find him wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." More angels appeared, and they praised God together, saying, "Glory to God in the highest. Peace and goodwill." After Jesus was born, kings came to Jerusalem from the east, asking, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and followed it here so that we might worship him." Learning that the prophecy named Bethlehem as the birthplace, they went on their way. The star they had seen went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. And they were overjoyed when they saw the child and his mother. They bowed down and worshiped him and presented him with gifts.
Christmas, sing we now, oh, oh.
As the angels, shepherds, and kings worship, may we also come and worship the one called Jesus. Let us kneel before him, for God has exalted him to the highest place. He has given him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. To the glory of God the Father, come, let us adore him.
Thank you. Thank you, one and all. What a wonderful job in helping us to remember what it means to be in loving relationship with our God, the Son, Jesus Christ, and his birth. What a wonderful commemoration. Thank you, choir. Thank you, Steve and Lori, for your direction. Thank you, Tom and all of the cast. Guys, you did wonderful. We deeply appreciate you being with us and sharing with us and celebrating this wonderful gift that has been given to all of humankind.